What is your name?
My name is Bryn Cummings, and I'm a ventriloquist.
How old are you?
I'm 12.
Where are you from?
We're from Pawpaw, Michigan.
How did you get into doing this? How did you know you could do this?
I remember seeing Darcy Lynn on AGT, and that inspired me. I literally looked at my parents as soon as I saw it, and I went, that's what I'm going to do.
And look at you now, right here in front of us. That's amazing. What are you going to do if you win $1 million?
I mean, it's a big thing, but probably I'd like to follow in Darcy's footsteps and start touring. To get like a tour bus, and I also really want a bearded dragon.
Oh, wow. Okay, we're ready. Go ahead.
All right, Penelope, it's our big moment. Are you ready for me to cue the music? I don't want to sing in the lar. What? This is what we've practiced for weeks.
I've been thinking about it, and it's been done. They want to see something else, something new.
But we haven't practiced anything else. What's your plan?
I've got it! Mentalism!
Mentalism?
Wait, what?
I don't mind, Reed. Quit playing around. Let's just sing the song. Trust me. Take me down to the judges. Is that allowed?
Yeah.
Sure.
Yeah.
She's so good.
She is good.
I have a bad feeling about this. Oh, stop worrying. Seriously? I don't know what I'm supposed to do.
It's okay, we'll use a deck of cards. Check your pocket.
Wait, what?
Ta-da! Heidi,
yes.
I'd like you to cut the deck one time. Howie, I'd like you to take the top card.
All right.
Then look away and close your eyes. Show me the card. I will send my thoughts to Drin using my brilliant mental powers.
What do I do now? Just concentrate. What comes to mind? A migraine. Drin! Okay, I'm focused. I see. I think it's black.
That's it. Keep thinking.
It's a club. Is it the Seven of Clubs?
Open your eyes.
Oh my gosh! What?
That's amazing. That's crazy.
Judges, in a moment, we're going to go back on stage. That as we do. Sophia.
Hi.
Please take out any item from your purse, but keep it hidden for now.
Okay.
Simon, please run out into the audience and grab an object. Any object from anyone. Yep, in the audience. And judges, don't let us see what you picked. Do not let us see what you picked. Let's make this a little more interesting. Terry, can you bring out the blindfold?
Blindfold?
Terry, inspect the blindfold. Hold it up to the light. Can you see through it?
No, I can't.
Perfect. Please put it on the ring.
Okay.
Make it nice and tight. Nice and tight.
Perfect.
Perfect. Thank you, Terry. You can go. You can leave now. Thank you so much. You're gonna figure out what objects the judges are holding. Sophia, hold your object up into the air. Drin, clear your mind. So Drin, what do you see?
I see it's a food. It has some sugar in it. It might be like a good treat. Maybe you leave it when Santa comes. Is it a cookie?
Sophia, what was your object?
It's an oatmeal cookie!
Oh my gosh!
Since you're doing so well, you're gonna try this one solo.
Penelope, come on, I need your help.
Fine, here's a clue. Simon's object can fit inside of this room.
Penelope, come on. Wait, I'm getting something. It's an accessory. You might wear it on your you wear it on your wrist. Is it an Apple Watch?
Yes.
Wow.
Oh my gosh! Wow! Thank you, everyone!
That's amazing.
so much fun. It's so great to see you right up close, how good you're doing it. I loved it.
Thank you so much.
This is the season of mashups. The fact that you did magic or mentalism and ventriloquism at the same time, you're amazing, young
lady. Thank you so much.
Yes, yes.
I loved it too, because you really figured out like a perfect little act for yourself. You're part comedian too. I thought it was a lot of fun. Well done.
Thank you so much.
When did you realize that you have magic powers?
When I was about 9 years old, I would say.
That's cool. You are so talented, so charming. People are going to root for you. You did something we've never seen before. And for me, you never want to see the same thing again, but not quite as good. You want to see it better or different. And that's what you did.
Thank you.
Okay, we're going to vote. Sophia.
I'm going to give you your first yes.
Second yes.
Welcome, welcome, welcome.
What is your name?
My name is Ryland.
How old are you?
I'm 10 years old.
And where are you from?
I'm from England.
So Ryland, okay. Oh yes, 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 he's from England, we know. What is your talent, young man?
Well, I'm a magician.
Ooh.
Wow.
How long have you been doing that?
Since I was 2, so 8 years.
Wow.
At 2?
I was born with magical powers, and my dad is a magician, and he gave me some of the magical powers that he didn't need anymore.
Wow.
Okay. And what about the $1 million? If you get it, what would you do with that?
I'll give some to my mom, my sister, and my dad, and spend the rest on Legos.
Oh. Okay.
Okay. Let's see what you've got tonight.
Thank you. Tonight, I would like you to help me create a brand new magic word.
A magic word?
But first, I have gifts. You see, I love drawing and colouring in, and I've drawn you each a picture to look at later. This one's for you, Howie.
All right.
This one's for you, Heidi.
Thank you.
This one's for you, Sophia. Yes, and this one's for you, Simon. Now, don't peek inside the envelopes. Don't let anyone else touch them. We'll get back to them later. What you're about to see is amazing, but I can't do it on my own. I need help. Luckily, I have lots of friends that love magic just like me.
Oh, hello there. Hi, friends.
We got a lot of friends.
Wow. I'll let each of you to pick one of my friends. Pick one of the numbers and I'll place it in this holder. You get to choose which position it goes in. There are multiple combinations and the choices are all yours. We'll start with you, Howie. Please name one of my friends.
Me? Mark.
And would you like the number 7 or 23?
I'll take 7, it's lucky.
And where would you like it to go? 1, 2, 3 or 4?
First, because I'm first.
Okay, so number 1. Heidi, it's your turn.
I choose
Would you like 11 or 26?
11.
And where would you like that to go? 2, 3 or 4?
4.
Thank you, Heidi. Sophie, it's your turn. Which of my friends would you like?
Skylar.
And would you like 24 or 10?
10.
And where would you like it to go? 2 or 3?
2.
Thanks, Sophia. And Simon, which of my friends would you like?
Jordan.
Jordan. And would you like 1 or 15? 1. And we'll try something a little bit different with you. Would you like to put it in last position or swap it out for another one? Okay.
He's taking my position.
Okay. Thanks, Simon. Now, let's look at the drawings you didn't use. As you can see, they're all different. We've got things like Lego, dragons, we've got burgers. So they're all different, yeah?
Yes.
Let's look at the drawings you did choose. You chose a snake, a slice of lime, a house, and some mountains. Each of you had a free choice of which drawing you wanted and, more importantly, where to put it. The snake looks like an S, the lion looks like a C, the house looks like an A, and the mountains look like an M. That spells the word scam, right?
Right.
Yeah.
I said that earlier, we're going to create a brand new magic word. That can be our magic word. Everyone shout scam as loud as they can on the count of three. One, two, three.
Scam!
But what if I told you that we knew what the magic word would be before you even picked it? At the beginning of my act, I gave you each a drawing to hold on to. I'd like to take the drawing out of the envelope and show it to everyone. As you can see, they match. Now, as well as having something on the front of their T-shirt, my friends also had something on the back. Look. Word equals scam. Now, look.
Okay, so I'm at AGT. I'm gonna go in, do what I need to do, get out as fast as I can.
Okay, let's go.
I can't believe I'm actually inside the AGT theatre. Right, there's a desk. Better be quick. Can't get caught.
What is he doing?
Something there. Oh, God, Simon's gonna hate this. What's that? Oh, my God, I've got one. Come on.
Now, you're probably wondering what I did at the desk, Simon. Well, hopefully you're not too mad. Watch this.
It says scam everywhere.
Look, scam, 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 scam. Sorry, Simon.
Whoa.
Hello. Hello. What's your name?
Magic Mike Jacobson.
Magic Mike Jacobson. So you're going to be doing magic.
That's right.
Well, what a coincidence to have that name and to be doing
pretty
what
convenient.
You do.
Yeah. The movie was loosely based on my life.
Okay. Now, how long have you been doing magic?
I did magic everywhere I could, from my home to barbershops and everywhere in between, and eventually kind of just rose and rose and rose, and would love to keep doing it, you know? So that's perfect.
Okay, and how old are you?
36.
36, and where are you from?
LA.
And how do you make a living? Do you make a living doing magic?
Not yet. I work in advertising by day, but this performance will determine whether I can quit.
Oh.
So we'll see what happens.
No pressure.
Yeah, no big deal. But actually a huge deal for me.
Well, let's see what you do. Are you nervous?
Exactly, let's see.
Yeah, I'm a little nervous. I'm also just excited to be here.
We'll wish you the best of luck, buddy.
Thank you.
Go ahead.
I'm gonna share something with you all tonight that every magician has, but no magician will show you for some reason. It's this. It's an invisible deck of cards. It's a bit hard to see in this light. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna burn the invisible deck from 52 all the way down to 1. At the end, Simon, you're gonna be a hero, as you always are in my heart. And you're gonna save one of the remaining cards from burning, but it depends on what Heidi and Sophia decide. Heidi, take that match. I don't want you to strike it and stare into the flame. Let's just say there's two groups, number cards and face cards. We need to decide whether you want to start to burn all the numbers or all the faces. Blow it out when you're ready.
Am I telling you?
Yes, please.
All the faces.
The faces are now on the fire. You can pass the box over to Sophia. Sophia, take your match, okay? Left in the fire, we've got jacks, queens, kings. Okay, the only way to divide those up would be, men and women. I want you to burn that match. And tell us, do you want to burn all the men, or do you want to burn all the women to a crisp?
Oh, the men.
That was a very quick decision. You go ahead, you blow it out. And you can pass that to Simon. You're gonna save one of the remaining cards from burning. All we have left are the four queens. Queen of hearts, queen of spades, queen of clubs, queen of diamonds. We're going to light that match. And whenever you're ready, blow it out. I want you to draw with that match the suit of the queen that you want to save. Hearts, spades, clubs, or diamonds. Is that a diamond? Here's the thing, are you sure? Simon, if you shake the matchbox, do you hear something in there? Open that up for us. Because in all of your hands the entire time, there's been nothing but one card sitting inside there, protected by a paperclip. I want to make sure, singed, like it's been in a bit of a fire. You guys could have saved whatever you wanted to, but you and you and you decided together to save the Queen of Diamonds. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you.
No.
I appreciate that very much, but this is America's Got Talent. I'm here to take this to the next level, and so, Howie, I don't know if you noticed, but there's an invisible deck of cards right next to your cup. Howie, if you would, I want you to just shuffle the deck for me, please. You might want to take it out of the box first. Oh. Thank you.
Stupid me.
Great. And now feel free to show off all your shuffling skills. Just make sure it's really mixed. Oh my God.
Oh wow.
That was very impressive.
It's so good.
Howie, whoa.
Now, Howie, what I want you to do is just fan out the deck to yourself and pick out any card you want. Don't show me, but remember it. Make sure everyone can see it. Great. Howie, if there's an invisible Sharpie right next to your cup, sign the back of the card for me, just with your first name.
Okay.
Great, I don't want to see it. And now, take the card, slide it right back in, put that all back in the box, and then throw it right back up to me whenever you're ready. Perfect. Now, you, just minor miracles, it's fine. Howie, you shuffled the deck.
Yes.
You picked a card. You all saw it for the very first time. What's the card that you picked?
10 of clubs.
I want to clarify something. You and I have never met, correct?
Never.
Nobody came up to you before the show, said
no.
anything?
No.
For the very first time, I'm going to open this up. You said the 10 of clubs, correct?
I did.
Because every single card in here is face up, except for one.
Uh-oh.
One card with a signature on it. Howie, can you confirm, is that your signature?
It is.
Will you flip that over for me?
Are you kidding me?
Is that your card? Thank you very much.
That's crazy.
Thank you. Thank you.
And he kept all his clothes on.
Heidi, what do you think?
I mean, the audience was so quiet. I haven't heard this audience this quiet all day. I mean, we were all like, like hanging by every word that was coming out of your mouth, and it was incredible.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Really cool.
I'm like mesmerized. It was like fantastic, and it was funny at the beginning also with the invisible part.
Yeah.
Thank
Good
you
job.
So much. Thank you.
I'm gonna make a prediction. No more advertising jobs for you. Because this is what I think you were born to do. Genuinely.
Thank you.
Yes!
Thank you so much.
I gotta say, and you know, people at home are always skeptical because they think, I swear to you, nobody here was in on this. This is my signature. That was incredible. I loved it, you know? I think it was really good, and I think you're really good.
I'm gonna start the voting with a yes.
It's a yes for me too.
Sophia?
Yes!
And Simon, 4 yeses!
Thank you. Thank you guys so much. Thank you. Thank you, Cheryl. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Hi! Welcome to America's Got Talent.
Thank you. Thank you.
Isn't it fun out here?
It's fun, man.
How is it when you're like in the wing, about to come out? Are you nervous then, or?
But Terry's back there.
What is he doing over there?
No, just, you know, giving motivational talks and everything. I think he has a TED Talk coming up or something. I don't know.
Okay, so tell us, who are you, how old are you, and where are you from, please?
My name is Orlando Leyva. I am 45, from Miami, Florida, and I'm a stand-up comic.
How did you get into that?
It's my wife. It was my birthday, and she gave me a gift to the school that teaches you improv acting. Mm-hmm. And then the improv teacher says, you're not good at improv. you should try stand-up.
And now you're here on the biggest stage in the world.
What a journey, man.
Take it away.
Thank you. Thank you, guys. Thank you.
I like this vibe.
Thank you, thank you. I'm happy to be here. My name is Orlando. I'm married, 15 years. You could hear it in my voice. There's a little essence of defeat every time I open my mouth. You hear it, like every good husband. Listen, woman, you wanna get gelato after this? Is that possible? She's a good woman. She got me into that show, Yellowstone. I love that show. Yeah, it's a great show, but I feel like less of a man every time that I watch. Should I buy a truck? I feel like I should buy a truck. For those that don't know, Yellowstone is a TV show about a cattle ranch ran by the bodyguard himself, Kevin Costner. Yeah, a man, right? Mm-hmm. The writing is great, the acting is excellent, but the visuals of Yellowstone are amazing. Yellowstone, the park looks amazing. So imagine my excitement when my buddy Eric invited me to his wedding. Where? In Yellowstone. Are you coming? Oh, I'm there. I've been watching the show. The second I landed, guys, I got it. This place was so beautiful, so majestic. I understood Kevin Costner. Shoot, I became Kevin Costner. By the third day, I was telling people to get off my land. Get off my land! Sure, it was in the hotel courtyard, but that's the way that I felt. I couldn't stop saying, go on, get. You go on, get. You go on, get from that cucumber water, sir. You've had enough of our minerals. Thank you. I drove out into the park. I'm a city guy, man, and I was out there in nature, unsupervised. I saw elks, the real ones, with the coat racks. I saw elks. I saw bears doing bear stuff. They waved at me. One got a little bit too close. I said, you go on get, Yogi. I told him. Here's a big one. I saw bisons. Those are real. I thought bisons were made up like unicorns, but there he was, a bison in the middle of the road looking like a bougie cow, moo. I see you, bougie cow. I see you. I kept driving because they told me to go see Old Faithful. Old Faithful, for those that don't know, is a thermal geyser that shoots water and steam out into the sky from the middle of the earth. Allegedly, I hadn't seen it yet. When I got there, they call it Old Faithful because Old Faithful always goes off right on time, plus or minus 10 minutes. I read the sign, and Old Faithful did not let us down. It went off right on time, plus 10 minutes. It reminded me of me in my 20s. I was like, I remember when I could do that. Yeah, I can't do that anymore. I can't. I'm more like old dependable. Or maybe later, plus or minus 10 days. It all depends how my tummy feels. My name's Orlando Leyva. Thank you so much, guys.
Orlando!
Amazing balancing I've ever seen.
Unbelievable.
Oh my goodness. I don't know if I can watch this.
Thank you.
Thank you. Howie.
That is the scariest, most dangerous act I have ever seen on America's Got Talent.
There were no nets.
Thank you.
I'm speechless, which is weird for me.
Good. I'll move on. Heidi.
This is how you do it!
Thank you!
I mean, you are daredevils. I'm sweating for my armpits so badly. I was screaming along. I love the two of you. You're amazing!
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Sophia.
That was spectacular. It was the most exciting, fun, scary. Even the moment that you looked like you were not gonna make it made it even better.
Unbelievable. It was from start to finish about as close to perfection I've seen over the years. You are absolutely brilliant.
Thank you.
That is very scary.
Okay.
We're gonna vote. Howie.
Yes.
Heidi.
A big fat yes!
Yes!
Sophia.
Yes!
I've done the numbers. It's about 4,000 yeses.
Thank you for having me.
Who are you and where are you from?
My name is Maureen Langan. I live in Manhattan, but I grew up in Lake Hiawatha, New Jersey, where there is no lake.
So what is your talent? What will you be doing for us today?
I am a stand-up comedian.
What got you into comedy?
Well, I say a gift from God, but really, it's you grew up in a big Irish Catholic family with five siblings. You're always taking the crap out of each other, and it's just part of a natural wit. I think. You'll see.
Okay, the stage is yours. Have fun.
Thank you.
And hopefully we have some fun with you.
I don't want to hate people. They make me hate them. I'm all about love. You feel that immediately with me. But I was on the airplane coming here, a woman in the seat behind me, she gets up and she starts spritzing cinnamon. I go, lady, what are you doing? She goes, well, it's natural. I go, so is my butt, but I'm not putting it in your face. I didn't want to hate her, she made me hate her. Do you see what's happening there?
Yes.
I'm a victim. I had a car accident recently. I'm all right, don't worry. Young guy, stoned out of his mind, on his cell phone, music blaring, looked a lot like you. Gets out of his car, you know, with the man bun. Dude, I don't know what happened, dude. I'm like, oh, what happened is in 1999, your mother forgot her birth control. That's what happened, dude. Well, wait a minute. I didn't want to say that. He made me say it. I was a victim. I was victimized. Okay, so but truth be told, I am at that age, post-period, pre-death. That's my age range, here it is. I don't wanna be a cougar, absolutely not. I don't need some young hot guy named Chad touching my belly fat going, ooh, what's this? What's this? This is rage. Rage, covered by affordable treats and wine from Trader Joe's. That's what this is. We got going here, baby.
Yeah.
Yes. Yes. You know what I want? This is what I want. I want a guy around 86 years old, where I am the hottest thing between him and death. He can't believe he got me, because he knows he'll never get anyone better to the day he dies. And he's not looking over his shoulder for somebody younger and hotter. You know why? He has arthritis in his neck. He can't move his neck. And he sees none of my flaws. He sees no cellulite, belly fat, varicose veins. Why? Cataracts. Cataracts. And you know what? Let me tell you something. I love him. And I look into his milky white eyes. And I say, I love you! Because he's hard of hearing and I want him to know. Because I'm all about love. Thanks, you guys. I'm Maureen Langan. Thank you. That means a lot, you guys. Thank you so much.
You're funny, Maureen. It's the timing. You just have this really good timing.
Thank
and
you.
Your voice and how you just like, bam, 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 bam. You just have the next one coming and the next one coming. I mean, I was laughing a lot. So were you. So were you.
Yeah, well, everybody was.
Were you laughing, Simon?
So funny, so fearless. That's what Simon says.
Thank you.
What about you, Sophia?
It was fascinating. Your energy, the way that you control the stage, you didn't miss one beat. You know your material.
She had like the body movement.
She was so cool.
Yeah.
You feel like you need to be like on a TV show, actually.
Thank you.
Yes.
You know, you have a voice where we can hear you and we can hear your rhythm and we can hear your attitude and we love it and we connect with it. I think people not only gonna love you, they will imitate you, they'll wanna see you. You have catchphrases.
Yes.
You have everything in that arsenal that a great comedian needs. You are ready to explode.
Thank you.
I wanted to love you and I did love you.
More women in comedy!
Let's vote. I'm gonna give you a first yes. You were fantastic.
Second yes.
Sophia!
I think people are gonna love you.
Thank you.
What do you think, Howie?
It's amazing, it's crazy, it's dangerous, it's wrong. You should change your name to Shishka Bob.
Heidi. Are you okay? Sophia.
I have mixed feelings. This is very disturbing and fun at the same time. It's like I like you and I don't like you at the same time.
I love that because we've seen this kind of app before, but the stuff I've seen before like this is tame in comparison, in my opinion. If anything, the app was too short. Okay, we're gonna vote. Howie, yes or no?
It's a yes for me. It's like crazy.
Heidi.
I want to say no, but I have to say yes.
Yeah.
I don't want to see you again, and I can't wait. Yes.
You've got 4 yeses. We'll see you again.
We're great, but are you okay?
I'm hanging in there, literally, hanging.
Did something happen to you, or you?
I was playing basketball, and I tore my Achilles.
Right before coming to AGT.
Yeah, I had to. I didn't want to miss this opportunity to perform for you guys, so.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
What is your name?
My name is Barry Brewer.
Barry, where are you from?
I'm from the south side of Chicago.
Yeah.
Hey.
Well, the good thing is that you, whatever you're gonna do, looks like you're gonna do it sitting down, no?
Yes, I was gonna do stand-up comedy, but I'm gonna do sit-down today, so.
Oh. How did you realize that you had that gift?
I'm a musician, and I grew up playing in church on the weekends, and this guy said, man, you're funny. I was playing the drums for this community choir. He said, you should do some jokes for the concert. And I said, for real? And I did a church performance, and I got a standing ovation my first time, and I've been chasing that dream ever since.
Oh, wow. Tonight.
Thank you so much.
Break a leg.
Thank you, Hal. I appreciate it.
I got
thank
you
so much.
I got you. There we go. All right.
Woo, thank you so much. Yeah, I did travel here from Chicago.
Oh my gosh, wow.
And when I traveled, I thought that, you know, I would get a little empathy because I was on crutches because I like to go on vacation and forget I'm black sometimes. Some people don't understand. It's a little stressful. But when I got on the plane, this young lady clenched onto a purse. You know how you have to stand in first class and wait to get to coach. And she clenched onto her purse like I was gonna take it. And I was offended for 2 reasons. First reason is I can still take it. You're not that strong. You know what I mean? Like, you ain't been in the gym like that. Your little strength ain't gonna stop my yank if I was a thief. And then second reason, where I'm gonna go? I have crutches. You think I'm gonna steal your purse and go sit in 32C? I just think everybody should love everybody, right? Like, I just really believe in that. And being a musician, man, I got to play for different churches. I grew up and I learned how to play in church, so I got to play for black church and white church. White church is a little more simple. Their Jesus is simple. The chords are simple. The pastor, he gets up, he does his message. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. Thank you, God, that whosoever believeth in him, you just have to believe, shall not perish, but have everlasting life. And church is over. That is church in white church. It's real simple to the point. Black church, I grew up, is different. You go to church on Sunday, and then when they preach, it's like serious, like, put your hands together for Jesus. He's been too good. Hey, yeah. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son,
that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. Put your hands together for Jesus. Hey!
I know white people be like, their Jesus is angry. Jesus is very angry. Their Jesus has been through a lot.
Good evening.
Hello.
Hello.
Who are you, beautiful girl?
I'm Mandy Muden. I'm from London in the United Kingdom.
How old are you?
I'm 29.
Oh.
It's been a rough couple of years, you know what I mean?
And what do you do, Mandy?
I do magic.
Why AGT? Now?
Well, being British, as Simon will back me up to say, I love America. Also, I owe money and had to get out of the UK.
What are you going to do with $1 million if you win?
Well, I'd probably spend it on men.
On men? Okay, we're ready for you. We want to see your magic.
Okay, fantastic. Right, everybody, are you ready to get into a magic mood? Okay, America's Got Talent. Look at this. Four strangers ready to judge me. It's like one of those parties where you throw the car keys into the fishbowl. Heidi,
yes?
Would you just... I've got a bag here,
yes,
full of letters. Could you just reach in and get a few out just to make sure that they're all different? It's very difficult with the gloves on, isn't it? If you just committed a crime and hoping to get away with it.
They all look different.
Lovely. Shove that back. I'll give the bag a bit of a shake. Hi, Howie.
Hi.
I want you just to take a letter.
One?
Don't look at it.
Okay.
Okay, fantastic. Could you take one as well?
Take it out?
Yes, please. And don't look at it. We'll come back to that later. Okay, Sophia, could you do the same? Okay, fantastic. Now, Simon, I'm going to riffle through my book. Could you just stick anything in you like?
Finger?
Yes, a finger would be lovely, Simon. Okay, brilliant. Now, Simon, could you look at the page number?
Yes.
And the first word on the page, Simon.
Got it.
Okay, and could you write them down and remember them?
Yes, I can.
Okay, fantastic. I'm just going to pop back up to the stage. Feel free to check me out, Simon. Okay. Right, here we go. Now, Howie, I want you to think of any word at all in the English language.
Okay.
Now, would you be impressed if the word you were thinking of was written on a piece of paper in the bag in front of you?
Yes, more than impressed.
Please open the bag.
It's a dictionary.
Unbelievable. Heidi and Sophia, open your packages. Okay, Heidi, what lovely love story do you have, Heidi?
Mine says 50 Shades of Grey.
Oh, now Simon, what page were you on?
70.
Okay, Heidi, could you turn to page 70? I'm just going to go into a trance and read your mind. Here we go. Page 70. Does your word begin with an F?
Yes.
Right, lovely. Now, are you familiar with this word?
Yes, I'm familiar with the word.
Okay. Oh my God. Now, the spirits are telling me that this word ends in I-N-G, okay? Have you done this word today?
Yes.
That's my girl, fantastic. Is your word by any chance, is it fantasizing?
Yes, it is.
Okay, now, Sophia, could you go to 70? Could you look at the last word on page 70,
Sophia?
Wait,
I don't have my glasses. 70.
Okay, Howie, you've got a dictionary there.
Yes.
Could you go to page 330?
Okay.
And could you go down 7 word entries?
7 words. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
What's
yes.
the word?
Loony.
No! It's loony!
Now, Simon, you were thinking of a word, you wrote it down. What was your word?
Eat.
Eat. How will you picked a letter?
Did yes,
you
I did.
Hold your letter up and shout it out?
It's an E.
An E. E. What do you have there, Heidi?
I have an A.
And what do you have, Sophia?
A T.
Unbelievable. Thank you so much.
Bravo.
Oh, wow. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Mandy, that was quite a surprise.
Oh.
You're so funny, and I didn't expect to have so much fun. Howie?
You're a very good magician. You're funny. I love you. I'm a huge fan of yours. You are the epitome of somebody that deserves to have their own show. I would go see you in Las Vegas.
Yes.
Oh, wow. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Heidi!
I think that you are adorable, and can I keep this?
Yes, of course.
Simon.
We saw everything, didn't we? I mean, you were mind reading, you were funny, you're very naughty. I really like you.
Oh, thank you.
I do.
So we're gonna vote. Heidi.
It's a yes from me for Mandy.
Oh, thank you so
Simon.
Much.
Simon.
It's a yes.
Howie.
Three yeses.
Oh.